Everybody, welcome back to some Star Wars Jedi Outcast. We'll be changing some crap around, soon. I think I have, Jedi Mind Trick now. That one's new. Any aggressive action made by the Jedi will alert the enemy. Oh, that sounds really awful. And it even actually spoiled in the text one of the enemies that we haven't seen before, but... yeah. Get him!
I think it's this way.
And I'm not allowed anywhere. Well, Lando, my good old friend. Can I force push him? No. Oh, also, I turned on dynamic crosshairs now. I'll explain it to you in a bit.
Ah, there's my baby. Hope they took good care of her. Give me a minute to check things out.
How's it look?
Well, it doesn't look like we can just fly her out of here. She's held in place by magnetic moorings, and they've got one tough tractor beam online. I can deal with those here, but that doesn't solve the bigger problem. The entrance to the pad is closed, and I don't think they're going to just open it up for us if we ask politely. You'll have to find the flight control center and open the door to the star pad. Better get going. I would guess we can expect some company pretty soon. Good luck, Kyle.
Thanks, Lando.
I will now go down. Now, you can see that, like, the crosshair really kind of changes depending upon where you look. If you've noticed, it doesn't exactly stick to the middle of the screen. That's why I originally had it off. But apparently, I actually shouldn't have turned it off, because one of the puzzles in the Nar Shaddaa area... the crosshair will turn blue,
Kyle,
when it can use...
I cut the power to the moorings, and I think they'll be in for a surprise if they try to use that tractor beam. But there are some safeties I need to remove manually. I'll let you know when I get there.
Good luck.
So the crosshair will turn blue when you can do a force fire, which also helps. And there's also one other thing I was going to change. Saber realistic combat 0. Because, allegedly, that actually might be making the game easier. I mean, everything here dies in one hit anyways, but, I think it maybe turns off the dismemberment, though. I'm gonna mind control this guy. Oh yeah, it completely turns off the dismemberment now. Yeah, let's turn that shit back on. Just for the time being, because everything dies in one hit anyways. Yeah, they see that now, off of his head. Alright, let's go... force speed into that room. Alright, well that's pretty much all I've learned for now. I will turn it off if I find it is actually hampering as I said, everything you've seen so far dies in one hit, but there is some stuff that doesn't necessarily die in one hit. As I said, for now it doesn't make a difference, but I may turn it off later in the campaign here. It's a very long way down. I've also done some stuff where there's a lot actually to the combat of this game. There's actually a guy, I forgot his name. I feel bad for not knowing. Just one second. This is probably not the place to actually use a lightsaber, but... might as well. Trying to find a... I can just jump up here. Thank goodness for light amplification goggles. Yeah, it probably really is making it easier, because I'm pretty sure I can't just walk into them and do that kind of shit. So maybe I will turn that off. After all, I think I'm changing my mind on that, so no more dismembering it, kids. You're gonna have to get your violent fix from somewhere else. But I can't do that right now, because I'm being killed by shit. I mean, right now, as I said, it's like, I'm kill them all in one hit anyways. Shit. Where's the guy that's fucking... he's over there. Shit. Yeah, fuck this guy. Alright, let me get the sniper that's all the way over there before I... fuck with anything else. I fucking hate these guys, honestly. Also, apparently I can use my walk key, whatever that may be. I don't think I have a walk key. I mean, why would you want to walk when you can run? Where is it? Walk, 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 walk. Somewhere. Apparently I may have just completely disabled walking. I don't know, I'm not gonna read this forever. You know, I could also strafe, I guess, but... Because he, like, fires, like, twice in quick succession while I'm, like, trying to lock in my aim. There we go, we got him. I mean, if we take one hit, it's fine. These snipers are ridiculous, though. You know what? Why am I gonna run up to these guys? Whoops. I did the thing where I wasn't actually, This is like, you know, maybe this weapon isn't so bad. Alright. Alright, we're good for that. What was I gonna explain to you guys? Oh yeah, I was gonna turn off the realistic combat now. Because I think it is actually making the game slightly easier. And, I mean, I loaded this on the hardest difficulty. I might as well play it on the hardest difficulty. Like I kind of started it up on, so... Is that Lando? What the hell is he doing down there? He's not even fucking using the control panel like he's supposed to. Oh well. Good game. So, that's it for pretty much that. Oh yes, there's a guy. You know what? I'm gonna find his name. Just give me a sec. Yes, okay, I got it now. It's Dark Shadow Rage 2. That's him. He was in my comments a bit, and he also... I think he told me about the music thing. Like, just turn the music down, and it gave me the idea to even run this game in the first place. But I actually had a quick look at his videos, because he's actually a big Jedi Outcast, or Jedi Academy buff, at the very least. The games are very similar. I think the combat is a little bit more different in Academy, but I don't really know. Because, as I said, I'm loading this game up for, like, the first time in like, a decade.
That gun's got me pinned down. Think you can take care of it?
I'll see what I can do.
Anyways, I was looking at some of his stuff, because it was interesting to me. And, so he's like, yeah, he's a big buff on Jedi Outcast. He has, like, all this kind of lightsaber stuff, which is kind of cool. And so, like, apparently the combat, with regards to how the lightsaber mechanics work, it's apparently much more complicated than I originally...
Thanks, Kyle. I should be okay now.
Anytime.
Apparently much more complicated than I originally thought. So apparently there's actually, like, I was watching some of the guys' lightsaber duels, and it was actually pretty cool. What people can do in these games. I mean, there's a community around, apparently, Jedi Outcast, as well as the game after this, which is Jedi Academy. So he's much better at it than I am. Like, I tried some of the maneuvers, I looked them up, and I just couldn't get some. Oh, wait, there we go, I can do that. Never mind. I remember this one. And there's one where I can, like, jump in the air with, like, the lightsaber. And I can do backflips, do side flips. And apparently, I can also roll. I think I could always do that, but... I don't know. That guy would have been dead. Oh, that fucking killed me, too. And I think I saved it back here. Okay, that's okay. So it's actually kind of interesting. So as I said, I'm not an expert. I don't pretend to be. I'm just like, as I said, I'm just playing a single player campaign. I'll just keep it going like this. I like this strategy. It's a good strategy. So I did the mine thing on him. This fucking sucks so much. Oh my goodness. Oh wait, okay, I just did that. One sec. I wasn't even trying to do that, by the way. Wait, this. Apparently I was making the combat much easier for myself. Because, yeah, you can see that they're not necessarily dying in one hit anymore, because I'm not dismembering them. But yeah. Okay, so we'll just keep that off for now on, guys. It didn't really make much of a difference in Narshada, trust me. That was all about the snipers and shit, so... Anyways, yeah, so those are, as I said, there's lots of this game. So, like, as far as I know, it's supposed to be, like... Like, I did it by accident. Oh, wait, it's kind of like... No, that's that was like a swing around. So there's apparently, like, you can combo, abilities here. I'm gonna just run up to him. Are you for real? These guys are insane. You can combo things, I can't do it that well. Like, it's like you hold one, like, yeah, like, you can do, like, a little swingy thing. Oh, you just hold it down, actually. And you can, like, it's depending upon the way you move, actually determines what kind of swing you do, and certain swings are better than others in different ways. It's actually, there's a lot to it, guys, and I thought it was really interesting. I'll kill this guy, too. I think I just should use this ammo for that for now on. Alright, let's have a look here. This is like... Oh. Wait, I thought he was on another control panel here somewhere. Why is he back down there? Whatever. Lando's in every place at once. Oh, he was behind me! I thought the laser went from the other place. Oh well. I saved it. It's okay. Da-da-da. There he is. Well, I wonder if I can get up there. Is there a way I can just kind of... I think I can get up there. Oh, just barely. Oh, that one kind of killed him in one hit. I don't know, it's just like... What are you gonna do, guys? I turned off my cheats. Not really cheats, though. Yeah, I did it again. Okay, I'm doing it totally by accident now. I'll be honest. It's now starting to annoy me, because I'm not even trying to do it. It's basically this backward swing maneuver. Die. There we go. Alright, who's up here? Makes it super easy to just kind of run up to him and stab him. That seems so cheap, though. Dude, Jedis are, like, heartless. Actually, they are, so, you know what? It's all according to plan.
Good work, Kyle. Looks like we have access to the star pad now. I'll start prepping the ship. Meet you inside.
He's gonna prep the ship. Alright, so there's actually one other thing I want to briefly tell you guys about, actually. I could have just gone this way. Interesting. This head's down here. So, in case you guys don't know, so like I told you guys already, I'm not using many mods. And I figured this was something interesting to bring up. Which was that, I'm not using any real mods, just like really small things, like the crosshair is better for widescreen and some other stuff, like basically all the graphical stuff you see is actually this engine itself, and this game came out in 2002, and you can kind of tell, because like you've seen the characters talk, like their mouths are like really kind of weird, but, you know, the game before this, Mysteries of the Sith, and technically Jedi, Dark Forces 2 Jedi Knight, they came out in, I think it was 1997, 1998, respectively. And this one came out 2002. And so, the first question you ask, or at least I ask, is, what the hell is the giant leap in technology here? Like, that one was like a pixelated fucking mess. Like, I don't know if you guys have ever seen that. I think I modded the shit out of that. And that one still looks like really kind of like the lighting is all bad and all that kind of stuff. So it's like, why is this one capable of such better lighting? And it's actually the case for a lot of games in this era.
Hey, buddy. Glad you made it. Unfortunately, they didn't bother the refueler. This should take a few minutes, then we're out of here.
We've got company.
Get to the ship.
You know what? Fuck this. I'm gonna fucking thermal detonate them. All right. So anyway, so yeah. So like it's a good question. I'm like, if you've ever played games from this era, you know, you're probably wondering like, oh, what the hell happened in that? Because like, think about the games you were playing 4 to 5 years ago. They did not improve by that margin. Are they still shooting Blando? I think they are. Okay, there's a lot of guys. Okay, fuck this shit. And Lando died. Yeah, I'm gonna be far faster on that. Where the hell am I now? I have to get all the way back there. So, like, to finish my thought, the graphical improvement that happened within that kind of 4 year time period. Because remember, also, StarCraft came out like 1996, Brood War 1998, I think. Anyways, so.
We've got company.
I think we're good. So the thing that happened though was that video cards, dedicated video cards were really not a thing, and like people didn't have them in their PCs, and then it became kind of like a must-have thing that everybody has a video card. So everything you saw was like basically software rendering, you know, which is essentially just like no dedicated video card. It's all the fantastic people at our fantastic work of the CPU, which is like not really a fast thing. Oh my fucking god. Oh, thank god I did it.
Hold them off while I try to start her up.
Oh, not again, please. I fucking may have just quicksaved it in a place where he's just fucking dead. Because he's fucking retarded. I don't think he's gonna live. He's like going on top of the ship and fucking dead. I have to now go back to the checkpoint or something. Oh, this is not so bad, actually. Thank fuck. Okay, I'm gonna just redo this.
That was close.
This guy's such a shitter.
Hold him off while I try to start her up.
Wow, he's not dead this time? Wait, we have to get to the ship? Like, actually get into the ship? Where the hell are they, though? Alright, well, we're actually back in this now. So yeah, it basically everybody got graphics cards, and now, yeah, games are good now. But there's like a weird time period during this, during all this bullshit, where, why do I get to, I had the feeling of a sniper was shooting me, I was looking out for him. I thought I heard something trigger where, and once again, I did that once again. How do I do that every time? I know someone's gonna tell me, and I'm not bothered to figure it out right now. I'm being cool amazingly by coincidence. Alright, nobody else is like coming up there to him, are they? I'm afraid to quicksave, I won't lie. Okay, you know what, this guy's right here. Look at this asshole, he thinks he's gonna stand there. Need another back to tank. Yeah, well. It was just one of those interesting things, you know, because I play a lot of games that I used to kind of play. I mean, you have yet to see me load up some kind of weird, like, Atari game or something, because it's just something I've never really done before. Alright, what's my objective now? I guess I gotta go talk to him. Because I think I defended it successfully.
Kyle, we've got a problem.
So what's new?
There's no fuel coming through the lines. They must have the valve closed at the main tanks. See if you can get out there and open the right valve. They use a code system to make sure you get the right one. And you'll still need to find the controls for the roof sections. They have to be around here somewhere. I'll get everything ready to go here. Good luck.
Alright, well, pump fuel to the ship. Wait, what's this? It's like, open the roof sections. What the fuck is this? Immediately! Oh. My own personal hell. I think they put enough snipers on the map. This map, I'm not too sure. Okay, we got him. I was pretty sure there was another one right there, but unfortunately, they're shooting me now from behind as well. This is like the best defensible place I've ever found. Fortunately, I'm not zoomed in enough, but I can't exactly change this on the fly. If I'm mashing my keyboard, it's not because of these guys, trust me. Oh my goodness. He's got like the perfect position for this kind of shit. You know, I think it's the only game I've ever played where it's like actually decent snipers. Can I just get on the roof from here? No. Alright, yeah, we can come back out there, that's fine. So obviously... Son of a bitch. We're just gonna go this way. I think this is the. This looks like fuel pumps essentially. So let's have a look at what the hell this stuff is all about. Whoops. Because I passed by this earlier. Just want to have a look at it. Okay, I don't really know the code, but you know, to be honest, I mean, it looks like only two possibilities. Like I could guess that. But, you know, I feel like I'd be that would be kind of cheesing it, so maybe we shouldn't do that. Alright, we can make it over there. And also, the other thing I've learned is to do all the jumps in first person, just because third person is kind of awkward. Ah, secret area. With Bacta. Apparently Bacta is not something you eat, but something you rub all over yourself. Which, I don't know what sounds worse, to be honest. That both sounds pretty bad, and funny in my head. All right, well they had a little roost up there. Okay, so this isn't the way forward, so we're gonna have to have a look around. There is one place I am kind of aware of that we can go to, so maybe I'll head there. I'm not sure if we have to do this after though, because I actually remember this from when I played this myself, because it's annoying as shit. Oh, it's actually this great. So it's possible the key is here, but it's also possible this is the way to kind of open up the valves. What's the... Yeah, they really don't die in one hit anymore, do they? Hopefully Landon doesn't die anymore. If he does, he'll become non-canon again. Okay, this actually looks like just the way to do pumps for fuel.
That's one. You'll need to open the other section.
I mean, we might as well just do this now, guys, I guess. Oh, now this opens. Wait, can't I go back in the vent? I'm sure it's on the other side. Where's the vent? Oh, right here. I need to roll more into these vents. Actually, this is not really that much faster. And I mean, the Jedi, you know, I was thinking, I'm like, oh, I could just use Jedi speed, but it actually doesn't really slow down anything other than... Okay, maybe it isn't on the other side. Okay, I may have been wrong on that. I knew there's something to that. I knew there was a grate there. I didn't think that was the way forward, so no, it's not actually the way forward. Alright, we were already there. You can always tell what's the way forward when there's like a zillion snipers trying to kill me. But, it's probably the same thing as last time with regards to the codes. Like, you know how it was like... kind of like... beeping at me and going like, oh, hey, that's the codes. We did that in like the first mission, I think, is when we used codes, so... we just basically have to find a way forward that isn't anything off. And I'm kind of curious to know if the answer to this puzzle is actually in his ship. He's got a nice ship, though. Look at his shit. Like a couch and everything. It's got like a, it's like a yacht, basically. This is kind of neat. You know, I'm going to explore the top of that in just a second. I'm going to just make sure that there isn't anything in his ship here. Okay. I'm pretty sure I know what that's for. Yeah, I know. Careful, Kyle. Okay, I'm pretty sure there's going to be something on top of the ship. There has to be. Okay, I think I just saw something floating through the world there, but, you know. Okay. This is kind of odd. I guess I'm not actually supposed to make it up there because it's all black. There's like no lighting or anything, so. Hey, what's up? I can actually see inside Kyle's head. That's horrifying. The first split second you can see it. All right, I'm gonna have a look around. I'll have a look and see what I'm missing. All right, so I did actually have to look this up, and this is one of those thinking outside the box things. Now, by the way, I was expecting this one to actually show up in blue, but apparently you can force push it or something. I guess not everything shows up in blue. I was kind of looking out for that, and I didn't think to try that, but yes, we can move the crate out of the way. I knew there had to be one on the other side. Force pushing is honestly the best way of dealing with these people. No, my shield. So this one handles this.
Nice work, the roof is open. We still need that fuel.
Alright, and now the last one. Now this one I actually don't think I ever knew. And the whole reason I even looked it up in the first place, like I'm pretty sure I probably would have eventually figured that out, but I was mainly looking for the code, and apparently it has to do something with on the things here. Oh yeah, because this one's actually attached to the ship, so right there. I actually never knew that. So this one is like the circle with a cross in it with red. And I think it's... what? Is that really it? No, there's another one right here. This one's actually the X, so... I never knew this, actually. I think when I always played this game, I think I randomly guessed it, because I couldn't figure it out. So that's something like I'm really not familiar with, because as I said, I would have just guessed it, to be honest. Because I'm like, there's two possibilities, I'll eventually get it. like, it's a crappy puzzle in that sense. Not enough combinations to deter me from just guessing it. But... I wanted to actually show you guys what you're supposed to do, and I'm like, you know, I never really did figure that out, so I already have that one.
Good work, yeah. Kyle. We're set to go. Get back to the ship and let's get out of here.
It's funny because I actually almost guessed it even without, like when I was showing you guys what the hell to do with it. It's not a great... that one's not really a great puzzle, but it's interesting if you try and do it the right way, you know? I don't know, I think it's funny as hell. Alright. Hello, Lando.
We're out of here.
That doesn't sound good.
I don't believe it. It's not my fault.
Uh-oh.
Going somewhere, gentlemen?
You'd better get on the gun and hold him off. I'll have this fixed in a jiffy.
And the gun is now on.
Oh,
God, it's a turret section in my Jedi Outcast. No Jedis.
This better work. All right, say goodbye to this wretched hive of scum and villainy, and hello to Cloud City.
Need any help?
Just sit back and get some rest. I'll work out a plan to get Desan and his remnant friends out of my city.
On second thought, Tavion, kill her.
Kyle! Oh!
Kyle, wake up.
No, Chen.
Kyle, are you okay?
Yeah, I'll be fine.
Good. While you were sleeping, I hailed a new Republic base on Sollust. They haven't shown much interest in our little smuggling problem in the past, but now that they know remnant forces are behind it, they're eager to pitch in. A strike team should be arriving on Bespin within a few hours.
No!
I thought you'd be happy to...
They'll tip off Desan.
Then we'll catch him later. Getting Desan isn't as important as clearing the city.
Jan's dead, Lando. Desan and his minion killed her.
Greif, I'm sorry, Kyle. Okay, here's what we'll do. I'll drop you off on the lower levels. They've probably been overrun by remnant troops, so watch out. Chances are that Desan's operating from one of the loading bays above level 10, but you'll never get in without the proper access codes. Try to find Carbonite Chamber 17. I've hidden an old R5 unit there with codes to every loading bay in the city.
You always did plan for the worst.
Ever since that run-in with Vader. Anyway, I'll head up top and gather some old friends from the security force. We'll work our way down towards your position. If we're lucky, we can trap Desan before the New Republic arrives.
That's it for today, guys. I'll see you guys next time. Goodbye.